Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about systems of equations today, and we're going to start off just saying, what is a systems of equation? A system of equations is when two equations are considered simultaneously. So if we think about them at the same time together, then it's a system. So it's just two equations that we're thinking about simultaneously. We are looking at linear equations, so we're talking about linear systems to the first power. Here's an example of a linear system. Here's a linear equation, another linear equation. That's a system of equations. Sometimes you'll see this notation here that kind of says that they're grouped together. If there is a solution to a system, it's an ordered pair because we have to know if it's a solution, we have to figure out what the x and the y are, whatever variables we're using there, but what are the two variables in that system? So one of the questions you'll be asked is the given ordered pair a solution to the system? And this you can do pretty quickly in your head usually. If I'm talking about this system up here, is negative 2, 3 a solution? Well, let's look at this for a second. And the first one, I'm going to take where I have x, replace it with negative 2, and then negative 5 times 3. That equals 10. And for the second one, I'm going to say y equals negative 2 plus 5. Well, over here, I can see that 3 equals 3. That's true. And over here, I have negative 4 minus 15. That does not equal 10. Negative 19 does not equal 10. So in order for this to be a solution to the system, it has to be true for both equations. So this is no, it's not a solution because it only solves in one of the equations and not both. Let's try the second one. I've got 2 times negative 5 minus 5 times 0. That's supposed to be 10. And I think I was supposed to have... Shoot. And the other one is y equals negative 5 plus 5. Well, y is 0, so 0 equals 0. And I think I was just made a mistake here and should have had something different there because what happens here is I have negative 10 does not equal positive 10. So this is not a solution either. I meant to have one that was and one that wasn't, but you never know. Plug them in. It has to be true for both equations for you to have a true statement. Okay. All right. Let's move on. There's not always an ordered pair that is a solution. There's three things, three different scenarios to contend to talk about when we're talking about a system of equations. Because when we're talking about a linear equation, like the one that I had up there, 2x minus 5y is 10, I could graph that and see what it looks like on a graph. When we're talking about a linear system, we're saying, what if we put both of those graphs onto a graph system? What would it look like? I could graph a line and graph the second line. Remember, we have two lines in the system. If I graph the two lines and they intersect each other, if the lines intersect at one single point, then I have an answer to my system, and that answer is an ordered pair, x, y. And that's what usually happens in this class. What is the answer to this system? It's 1 over and 2 up. So the system solution would be 1, 2, because that's the point where they intersect. The solution to a system, if there is a solution, is that point of intersection. It's the one point that the two lines share. I'll write that out because it's really important. The solution to a system is the one point that lies on both lines. And okay, so it's the point of intersection if we were to graph it. So we don't always have a point of intersection. As I can, you can see in the second scenario, both of my lines, they're parallel. And so they're never going to intersect. If the lines are parallel and they never intersect, then we say there's no solution. If they intersect in one point, they have that point as a solution. That's the one point that's on this graph at the same time it's on that graph. That makes that their point of intersection and the solution to that system. I drew this one so you could see I had one. It's supposed to be one on top of the other. It looks like I drew them just side by side, but they're actually one on top of the other. And when that happens, when one line falls on top of the other line, then we say the lines are coinciding, or lines coincide. If the lines coincide, they share every point in common, and so we have an infinite number of solutions. So those are the three things that can happen. You can have points, two lines that have a point of intersection, have no points of intersection, or have an infinite number of intersections. And again, a system is a solution to a system if you find an ordered pair that works for both. If it doesn't work for both, then it's not a solution. Okay, that's the first video. We'll be on to new things in the next one.